Good morning, everyone. It's really a pleasant morning today because it's already a rainy day. It has been raining since yesterday, and we are doing the poem The Voice of the Rain. Last week we did, but it was scorching heat those days when we did that poem. But now today we are going to conclude it by giving the, you can say, I would be giving the viewpoint about this poem, The Voice of the Rain. Fine. A gist of it only, because we have read in detail already. After that, I would be, you can unmute yourself at any time and you can speak. Fine. I'm not going to mute any of you because you would be giving the answers today. Okay, beta. So let's start. Open your books, beta. Page number 41, The Voice of the Rain, written by Walt Whitman. So this poem, Walt Whitman has narrated very simple incident. Actually, he is making proper use of poetic device personification here. He is making rain speak to us. He would be posing a question to the rain and rain would be answering to him. Fine. So we won't be doing paraphrasing, or I won't be explaining each and every word, because we have done already in detail. Okay, Jacqueline Mitter, please try to join well in time. Okay, always you are 5 to 10 minutes late. So please, whenever your period starts, join well in time. Okay, so in this poem, the poet Walt Whitman, he asked soft falling shower of the rain that who it was. Fine, he asked about the identity of the rain. Clear? And strangely enough, it was quite strange that rain shower gave him the answer. The voice of the rain speaks to the poet. Fine. And what does it say? The voice of rain told him that it was the poem of the earth. Why it is poem of the earth? Because it has a rhythm in it when it falls on the ground. Fine. It produces a melodious sound, as well as it soothes one's soul. So there are two reasons. It rejuvenates the soul of a person, as well as it has rhythmic sound. The same purpose which music also has. Fine. So that's why it says that it is the poem of the earth. It is everlasting and perpetual. Then it tells about that it is everlasting. It keeps on coming back to this earth. Then it says, it is impalpable. Impalpable, we have discussed in detail, that which cannot be touched, which can be felt only. Fine. And after that, rain tells that it has then the cyclic movement, which we have discussed the scientific phenomena of rain, the rain cycle. In that, it is born out of the land and the deep sea. In the form of vapors, it reaches the sky, and then in the form of clouds, it enters it converts its form, fine. And after that, again in the form of droplets and showers, it emerges back into its own origin, that is earth and deep sea, land and deep sea. So this process goes on and on. This is perpetual. Clear? Then after telling about its cycle, it just tells the purpose of the rain. Fine. What is the purpose of the rain? It would be telling us that it just enters the earth to, you can say, quench the thirst of tiny particles of on the earth, of the plants, whosoever needs it. Fine. It removes the dust layers of the world. Then the rain helps the seeds. Fine. Second purpose is, there are many seeds which are latent, which are unborn, lying there without any purpose. Only rain is the reason behind their germination. Fine. So after telling that, it quenches the thirst of the dry land. It helps the seed to take birth. Fine. To germinate. And then the process of rain goes day and night. Rain gives back life to its own origin, its own beginning. And it makes the earth more beautiful. It purifies it. And then the rain also sings a song. Then it compares, the poet compares the rain with the music. It says that rain sings a song. The song issues from its birthplace only. It keeps wandering here and there. It keeps lurking here and there. And after fulfilling the purposes after quenching the thirst, after germination of the seeds, find all the purposes when done, then it returns back. Whether anybody pays attention to it, whether anybody pays heed to it or not, that doesn't matter to it. It keeps on moving, the cycle keeps on going, and it keeps on helping the world to survive. Fine. So after accomplishment, the song, this song or this rain returns back to properly to its place, and with love, duly with love, it returns again. Right. So this is the poem which will tell us about the importance of the rain. Okay, importance of the rain and purposes of rain. Clear to everyone? Send me thumbs up. Yes, Sahajpreet. Upward to heaven again means this is a cyclic movement only, but the poet has given an emotional touch to it, a literary touch to it. He is telling us the scientific phenomena of rain, as well as it is telling us the metaphorical meaning, that how rain is quite important for us. Fine, it goes back to heaven means after fulfilling its purpose, it goes back again towards heaven, towards the sky, to take the form of the clouds again in the form of then shower. It just comes back again to its own origin, that is land and sea. Fine, so this purpose goes on and on. It comes to the earth, it goes back to the sky. It again comes to the earth, it again goes back to the sky or heaven. Fine, one and same thing here. So this circle moves on and on so that we people can survive on this earth. So it is quite important, but we people never pay even heed towards it. So rain is very important. Clear? It is just, this poem is unveiling the importance of rain to us. Clear? Now it's your turn. As you can see on the board, beta, here I have written question answers, but I have not answered anyone. Fine. Now you would be telling me, okay? As you can see that questions are written, but answers are not written. Why I have left it blank? I have the marker. I would be writing the answers, but I prefer that you people would be giving the answers to me. Okay, beta? So the first question, we have just completed the gist. Once you have just joined the meeting, beta, kindly join well in time. We are already 10 to 15 minutes late. Tomorrow onwards, I won't allow otherwise, please. Okay? So, beta, question answers are on page 42, as I already told you here. There are two voices in the poem. Who do they belong to? Which lines indicate this? So you would be answering me, I would be writing the answers. There are two voices in the poem. Who do they belong to? I'm just coming to that side to write, and you just unmute. Any one of you raise hand, or anybody can unmute and speak. Yes, beta. Who would be giving answers? I would be writing here. Otherwise, I would name the child. Raise your hands. Diksha, Anjali, Vaibhav, there are two voices in the poem. Who do they belong to? Yes, you can speak. Anjali, unmute yourself, beta, and speak.
Ma'am, there are two voices in the poem. First voice is of poet, and second voice is of the rain.
Very good. So there are two voices. First is of poet, and second voice, you won't be writing this way. Fine. In your notebooks as well as in exam also, I have written just as a gist to you. Fine. So there are, you will be writing complete sentences. Fine. That there are two voices in the poem, the voice of the rain. The first voice belongs to the poet Walt Whitman. Clear? You won't be writing poet only, you would be writing the name. That shows that you have the knowledge. You have read the poem and you know the answer. Clear? So the first voice belongs to the poet Walt Whitman, and second voice belongs to the rain. Very good. Second question goes to, I would be naming and you will unmute. Okay, Jacqueline, you can answer this question now. What is the strange phenomena? The question is, the poet, what does the phrase strange to tell mean? Yes, Jacqueline? If you don't know the answer, even then unmute and say that, ma'am, I can't answer. This is not the way. If I keep on naming you, you will unmute and tell that you can't answer. Jacqueline, unmute yourself, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta, what is strange to tell? What is strange? Do you know or yes or no? Dia, can you answer this?
Ma'am, poet has trained that the poet has translated this message of rain and give that I am the poem of the earth, said the voice of rain.
Very good. So you are not able to explain properly. Strange thing is that rain is giving answer back to the poet. Fine. What is strange here? Rain is rain, which is not supposed to speak. Poet has personified the rain. Okay. So what we would be writing, that rain gives back answer to the poet. Fine. So we would be writing that what is strange to tell. The phrase refers to strange phenomena. The rain gives an, the rain replies to the, see, replies to the poet. Clear? The rain replies to the poet. So this is a strange phenomena. Rain doesn't speak. So poet has personified the rain and rain is giving answer back to the poet, that is strange. Now, third question is parallel between rain and music. Who would answer that? I would be naming the child. There is a parallel drawn between rain and music. Which words indicate this? Explain the similarity. Just I have explained to you beta. Who would answer this question? Okay, Manjot. Unmute yourself and speak beta. Very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Speak loudly, Manjo.
Ma'am, I am.
Parallel means a similarity. What is the similarity between the two?
Ma'am, the similarity is that the rain has been compared to the music here. Ma'am?
Yes, try to speak it. Very good.
Ma'am, here in this poem, the poet Walt Whitman has compared the rain with the music, that when the rain falls, it produces a very good sound. And here in this poem, the rain is compared with the word. The music of the rain is compared with the word. The
very good. You got it. You got it. Now you're coming to the point. I would like to compile this answer now. Very good, Manjot. You can mute yourself. Because there are voices interrupting from the houses, try to sit at the silent place, otherwise mute yourself, right? When you speak, you unmute. So the question is parallel. Parallel means with a similarity, fine? So they have asked about the phrases also, that which tells us the similarity between the two. So both rain as well as music, they have rhythm. So I would be writing the key points here. You will be writing it. Sentences beta. Clear? You are in class plus one. You can write in sentences. I am just writing the value points of the answers. First common thing between the two, between the rain and music, is both have rhythm. Clear? And then after that, it says that beta, both have a source of origin. Fine? The way music originates from the soul, a person, you know, you might have seen many, you can say, composers are there, many people who are making tunes of music. Let me make the students join. Yes, Mitali, what happened to you, beta? Very late joining. I won't be marking present those who join after 15-20 minutes. Kindly see to it from tomorrow onwards. It's not allowed, please. So we are doing the question, beta. Those who have joined now, parallel between rain and music. Clear? First is rhythm. Both have a kind of rhythm in it. Then both originate from a source. Originate from source. Clear? So there is parallel between the two. Then both give us a feeling of fulfillment. What is fulfillment? Rain has a purpose. In scientific way, without rain, we cannot survive. Farmers need rain. We people need rain. Plants need rain. Seeds will remain unborn, latent. Without the importance of the rain, we cannot survive on this earth. Fine. So rain is quite important. It gives us fulfillment. Similarly, music also, you know, soothes the soul. It gives us a kind of fulfillment. Clear? So these are the common points between rain and music. Only 2-3 questions are there in this point, but total 6 questions are there. But I would be making you write some additional questions also. Clear? Then beta, next is cyclic movement of rain brought out in the poem. Fourth question. Now, boys also, beta, Raman. Where is Raman? Unmute yourself and speak. Ramanjeet Singh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta. Now you give me the answer of cyclic movement. We have already done in the poem.
Ma'am, cyclic movement here refers that rain that rises unpalpable and
impalpable, okay?
Impalpable and gathers and forms clouds.
First point is here, it rises impalpable from where? From where, beta? Tell complete answer.
From the land and deep seas, bottomless seas.
Now you are coming to the point. It rises impalpable. Now you have improved your vocabulary. We should use impalpable meaning. Raman, you tell me.
I'm untouchable.
Untouchable. Very good. Rises impalpable from land and sea. Second point now, Raman, tell me.
And ma'am, it gathers in sky where it
beta, this is changes. Very, it is not language of a class plus when it gathers in the sky. No, it you know reforms it in the form of vapors, vapours. Okay, so use that language which is up to the level of class plus one. It takes the form of vapors and goes to the upward sky or heaven, you can say, and take the form of clouds. Clear? Now, third point, tell me, Raman.
And then it showers and returns to its place of origin.
Showers back to its own origin. Very good. Board is visible to everyone. I'm just trying to. That's it. I would be now. Next two questions. But we would be just discussing. Now the term goes to Mithali. Unmute yourself, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
You tell the answer of the next question. Next question is, why are the last two lines? Okay, I won't be asking this question to anyone. I have not explained. I would be asking, list the pairs of opposites found in the poem. Have you found any opposites in the poem? Very easy question I have asked you, Mithali. Just see the poem. Just see the poem and speak.
Day and night.
Yes, Dia and Mithali both are correct. Day and night. One more. There are actually two more.
Ma'am, rise and descent.
Very good. Rise and descend. Yes, Raman, right. Rise and descend is the first set of opposites. Second is day and night. And third one, one more is there.
Birth and place.
No. Who else will answer? It's very easy. See the last lines.
Ma'am, ragged and unragged.
Yes, very good. Who spoke this answer? I could not find out easily.
Ma'am, Diljeet.
Okay, Diljeet. Well done, beta. So, ragged and unragged. So, there are three sets of opposites. Fine. And now I would be giving answer to the fifth question. Why are the last two lines put within brackets? If anybody knows, maybe I explained that day last week, but that not was in, I haven't given stress.
It is a song. Ma'am, it is a song. It is a song.
It is a song. Okay. So I would be explaining to you now. Now everybody, I'm going to mute you. Clear? Now I would be speaking so that there is no disturbance from your side. Well done for the participation. Maximum students are giving answers. It means you are paying attention to, and today you have test also. Clear? You might get question from Voice of Rain also. You can get from the previous syllabus, whatever we have covered so far, posters, notice, fine, and all the chapters, Portrait of a Lady, Photograph, Clear, Voice of Rain, whatever we have done, anything can be there. Okay. So be ready exactly at 5 o'clock. Now the question is, why are the last two lines put within the bracket? The last two lines, beta, actually it contain a comment. Fine. Poem is finished. Then it contains a comment about the music and its cycle. Fine. And you can note down the value points. So these actually differ from the spoken by Rain, you can say. These lines are telling us the major importance of the rain, that people do not pay attention towards it, towards the purpose of the rain. Cycle of the song is also put within brackets to mark the difference in speakers, but similarity in content. There is similarity in the content of songs as well as in the rain. Fine. But they have same purpose also. So just tell the highlight the importance of the rain. It is within the bracket. Fine. It is a comment upon the importance of rain by the poet at the end of the poem. So that's why he has just bracketed it. Okay. So we have done all the questions which are textual. Now I would be making you write some bit of extra questions, additional questions. So write down. What is the deep meaning? What is the deep meaning of this poem? What is the deep meaning, or metaphorical meaning also you can say, or deep meaning also, fine. Deep meaning of the poem. So beta, firstly you will tell that the poem is not merely a description of life cycle of rain. When we read the poem, it seems to us that it is just we are reading about the life cycle of a rain. But actually, it has deeper meaning. Clear? It has deeper meaning. Rain is a poem, or it is a thing of, it is a beauty of the earth, actually. Clear? It is the poem of the earth. It is the beauty of the earth. And it is the song of the earth, you can say. And it, the comparison between rain and music, and their function. What is the function of music? What is the function of rain? There are similarities. We have already discussed in the parallel wala question. Find that you can mention here. That both the things are making the earth or rejuvenating the soul. Music rejuvenates our soul. Rain rejuvenates the earth. Both have rhythm in them. Both are, you can say, originate from a source. And after, you can say, they have the purpose of fulfillment also. They fulfill our needs. When we are depressed, we listen to the music. When rain is parched and dry, it needs rain. When earth is, dry, all the particles needs, they need rain. Clear? So after that, next question is, justify the claim of the rain. Next additional question is, justify the claim of the rain. I am the poem of earth. Justify the claim of the rain. I am the poem of earth. So how can you justify that I'm the poem of the earth, beta? So the rain narrates the journey of its life. Fine, it is narrating the journey of its life from birth to return, and in mythical term as well as in scientific term. Clear? The facts are no doubt scientific, but the phrases that convey the cycle of the rain, they are very literary. Fine, related to literature. They are very literary phrases which poet has used to narrate the journey of the rain. So the whole journey has a beauty, the whole journey has a charm in itself. That's why you can say it is claiming that it is the poem of the earth. Clear? It has rhythm also in it. All the points, beta, again and again, same thing is there. Then next, last question is, what are the functions performed by rain? What are the functions performed by rain? Yes, tell me. What are the functions performed by rain? Anybody can tell? New student, those who have not spoken earlier. Same students are giving answer. But a maximum participation is required. What about Harman, Vansh, Ishnur, Sahaj, Prabdeep, Gursimran? Beta, you need to speak. Okay, Arshpreet, unmute yourself. Functions of rain, very easy. What are the functions of rain? Last question it is. Arshpreet, are you there? Fulfill the thirst of every individual. Beauty to nature, fresh air, environment. Yes, many students, those who are writing the answers to me. Yes, it is correct. But beta, when your turn is there, you need to speak. Whether you know the answer or not, you should tell. Fine. So there are many functions of the rain. And firstly, it quenches the thirst of the parched land. P-A-R-C-H-E-D. Parched land. Clear? Then it makes the flowers and plants bloom. It is the reason behind their survival. Then it beautifies and rejuvenates the earth and the atmosphere. Fine. There are numerous purposes, but you have to write which are mentioned in this poem only. Clear? Don't write about the essays that during the crop season farmers are in need and all. No, whatever is mentioned in this poem, in context to that you will be writing the functions of the rain. Okay, any doubt to anyone? We are done with this poem, beta. Now any doubt to anyone? It's already 11:24, 1 minute is left. You can ask me right now. Send me thumbs up if it is clear to everyone. Okay, so let me give you instructions. I have already put in the group about the test. You need to write your a particular format I have sent. Firstly, you will be writing roll number, name and class. You won't be using the word roll number, fine? Because they are when I'm going to save the test, it becomes easier for us to see the roll number wise. Fine, it automatically saves when it starts from the numeric, like 01 02 03 04, the way you will be writing your roll number, then your name and class. Fine, and within the given time it will be a short test, and you will be sending it in the form of PDF and click the picture of whatever is written over there. So actually this test is preparation for the exam in itself. I would get to know what kind of handwriting you are using, what is your presentation, how you are sending me the PDFs, whether you are renaming it or not. Fine. So we learn by doing mistakes only. Clear? So it is compulsory whether you have attended the class or not. Those who are absent also, they are also supposed to appear in the test. It is compulsory so that I can get to know the performance of each and every child. Okay, beta, with this, I'm leaving. Okay, the time is over now. So prepare well for your test. All the best, beta. Have a good day.